how to get toned arms for the summer. Mostly working on our shoulders.
What else are you going to work on?
A little bit of our triceps. Well, mostly our triceps and a little bit of biceps with jump push-ups. So we're going to do upright rows, 8 reps, 3 sets. We're also going to do front raises, 8 reps, 3 sets. We're going to do body rolls, which I'm not going to be able to show you in this video, so look for a link for another video. Push-ups, dips, and body ups, which I showed in a previous arm day video. So I'm going to first show an example of upright rows and front raises. You can do these with dumbbells or a barbell. If you don't have weights at home, you can also use gallons of water that you can use as weights. Or if you don't have gallons of water, you can then just practice working your muscle, period. So I'm going to use a bar for my upright rows and probably my front raises because I don't like using dumbbells too much. It's a little too heavy for me. The type of dumbbells, well, the weighted dumbbells that I have right now. So I'm going to show you, which is basically the same weight. It's just evened out a little differently. I'm going to show you with an upright, with a barbell. So we're going to start with upright rows, barbells. So this is my barbell. It's really an easy curler, but I don't really, but it'll do. If you want, if it's too light, this is 15 pounds. You can add weights to the end. So an upright row is a couple of different ways you can do it, is everything. But I'm just going to show you this. So you're going to just come straight up to your chest. Straight up to your chest. Or I guess your collarbone. Okay? So this is from the side. Make sure you hold your core and your shoulders, your feet are shoulder width apart. And you're breathing. Okay? So that's working your shoulders. For front raises, you can do the same thing. Use the barbell or dumbbells if you have lighter dumbbells. See if I can. Okay, I want to make sure I'm going to clear my desk, my dresser. So again, shoulder width apart, core in. Okay, this is from the side. Hold your core in and lift the weight up to basically eye level. Now, if you want to go higher, that's perfectly fine. So I'm going to show that from a higher version where you're going all the way up, which could be a little bit more difficult. But that's also going to work your back, your traps, which is your upper back. Which is nothing wrong with that. Gives you the sexy back when you want to wear racer backs. Okay? So I'm also, okay, so I'm going to not do the body rolls at all in this video. But include them when you do this workout. Again, I'll have another video having an example of the body rolls for no weights. It's really, you can do it off a table. But since I don't really have a table in this room, I'm just going to do a separate link for it. So look it out in the description box. So you know how to do push-ups, you know how to do dips, and you know how to do body ups. So let's just get to it. So we're going to do eight reps, 3 sets of everything except for push-ups. We're going to do 9 reps, 3 sets. We're going to push ourselves this time. So let's get started. Again, if this weight that you're using is a little light, try to go a little bit heavier, but not too much. Okay? So let's begin. Make sure your core is in and you're looking up. Make sure the bar is loose in between shoulder width apart. I'm sorry, I cannot speak right now. And up. Okay, so that's 1 rep. All right, so now you can take a breather, take a break, drink some water, make sure you're staying hydrated throughout your workout. If you feel like you might want to up your reps right now, up your weight right now, go ahead. I'm going to go into the next set, which will be set 2 for the upright rows. All right, hold your core in. So that's set 2. Again, make sure you're breathing, holding your core in. I'm gonna go right into set. Jeez, I cannot talk today. Into set three. So then after we do set three, I'm gonna go and do front raises. Now, you might see me do it a couple of different ways. You can do it, if you have dumbbells, you can do it like this, or you can alternate if they're a little too heavy. But when you do it, I guess if you alternate, try not to go too high up. So I really don't, I mean, you can do it, but I really suggest try to go parallel. Parallel. Or you can go all the way up with the dumbbells. Okay, so this is the last rep, last set for upright rows. Don't know what's wrong with me today. Now you should really be feeling these in your shoulders. Your shoulders should be starting to feel a little bit warm, a little bit of a burn. I say it's always good for women to work out their shoulder. It gives you that illusion of the smaller weight. As it's as good as to work out your lats a little bit. Now I'm not going to say go overboard and work your lats out, but work your lats out a little bit and eat clean, work your thighs out, and you'll get the curve figure that most women are looking for. But you got to work everything out, okay? Don't skip just, you want to do legs just because you want curves. If you really want that hourglass shape that you're looking for, work your shoulders, eat clean for your abs, and then work your glutes hardcore. So, now I'm going to do front raises. And I'm probably going to go all the way up. Okay, just make sure your feet are shoulder width apart. You're standing straight up. Your core is in. You can go all the way up or you can do parallel. It doesn't really matter. 8 reps, 3 sets. This is set 3. For set 1. Can't get the reps and the sets separated today. Try not to swing your weight if you're gonna go all the way up. If you notice that you're swinging the weights just to try to get it up there, then you're not really working anything. Try to just go parallel and then lower your weight and try that, okay? So you really don't wanna swing weights. That doesn't really help you and it could injure you, okay? So make sure I still got enough time. Okay, so now let's do set 2. Of front raises. I'm gonna do an underhand grip this time and just gonna go parallel. So if you really, if you want to switch it up each time you do your sets, so the first front raises we did overhand, second one we're gonna go underhand, and then the third I'll figure it out. We might just go back to overhand, okay, or I might go overhand parallel, okay? So it's okay to switch it up. I know I do. It gives me a little bit of variety and makes the workout more fun, as I'm still working the same type of muscle, but just in a different angle. So this time, make sure your feet are shoulder width apart, your core is in, you're standing straight up, and you're breathing. Don't be like unemployed Sean. Use your smartphone smarter. Try one of the hundreds of thousands of titles at Audible.com, an Amazon company. Click the banner to download your first audiobook free. Okay. So front raises might have been a little bit harder. If you did try it, you can go back to the underhand grip for the last one, which is what I'm going to do. So make sure you just make your workout fun, okay? Challenge yourself. It's not really going to be fun if you don't challenge yourself. See what you can do. There's endless of things that you can try, okay? Just push yourself to the next level every workout. So I'm going to do underhand front raises, and I'm not going to go all the way up. And I'll do these for the side. Okay, make sure your core is in, you're standing straight up, your feet are like shoulder width apart, and begin. A little bit. If it's really- want you to do heavy bouncing, like a disco dancer or some dancer trying to do something, okay? You can do a little bounce to get the weight up, but once you want to catch it here and bring it up, okay? So you really make sure you're working your muscles. Don't cheat yourself out of a workout. Then you just wasted your time. So now we're going to do the push-ups. Now, I would be doing body rolls, but again, I'm going to put a link in the description box below of me doing an example of that. I cannot do that in this room right now, but I definitely will be putting the link in the description box. And you'll be doing 8 reps, 3 sets of those. So since I can't do that, I'm going to move on to push-ups, which is 9 reps, 3 sets, then dips, and then body ups. Okay. So we're going to do push-ups. You can do modified, you can do whatever you want. Just make sure you're working your way through it and pushing yourself. So now we're going to do 9 reps this time. Okay, so that's 9 reps. That's set 1. You should start to feel your arms should be a little bit warm. You should feel the burn. Okay, so if you want, you can take your water break. I take about 30-second breaks if I need it. If you notice, I've been taking shorter breaks to keep the muscle pump going, and it helps burn a little bit more calories. So, make sure that we're doing 3 sets of this. Yep, 3 sets. So let's do set 2. I'm actually going to try it out. Try doing some of it without the modified. I really want to get my push-ups down packed. Push-ups are hard for you, just like they are for me. Do it the way I just did it. You can do it, start off with trying out the military push-ups, regular push-ups, and then as it gets harder, try to do 1 more rep of the hardness, and then you can drop down to your knees and then push yourself the rest of the way through. So that's a good way to do it. I can only do 6 right now, which makes it good because those last 2 reps, I'm really pushing myself and working my muscles the way I wanted to. So, now that I've had a breather, let's do round 3. Make sure you're drinking water. Hold your core when you do push-ups. Now, this is how I cheat abs. Seriously, guys, I rarely ever work abs. I just really don't. This is how I really kind of like cheat working them out after a workout. I hold my core in for everything. When I squat, I hold my core in. When I do overhead shoulder presses, I'm holding my core in. When I did the bicep curls, I was holding my core in. It's like a constantly doing plank version, okay? So when you do these, make sure you're holding your core in as if your belly button is trying to knit to your spine, okay? Alright, so I don't think I'm gonna really attempt. I'll do it anyway. What the heck? Alright, so this is the last set, I'm hoping. Yes, I think it is 8. Alright. Okay. Whew, push-ups are so hard for me. I'm so sorry. So now that we did our push-ups, next we're going to do, I do believe it's dips. Okay. Yep, it's dips. So I'm going to use my trusty nightstand. So I've done an example of dips before in a previous video, so I'm really not going to show it again. I'm just going to go through the reps and the sets. So that's 8 reps, 3 sets, then we're going to go down back down to the floor and do body ups for 8 reps, 3 sets. Again, I'm not going to do examples for those because I have a video where I did an example of that already. I might just make sure you say that. Make sure you just do a correct form, okay? Hold your core in. I'm getting away with it again. 8, Let's go. Make sure your elbows are pointing back. Alright. So that's the first set. You can take a drink of water if you need it. If you feel like you can do right back into the next set, then just go straight into it. Make sure you're not too far away from the table, bed, chair, couch, whatever you're using. And that you're going long enough to feel the burn in your tricep. Okay. So by now, if you're doing it back to back like I am, if you're keeping up with me, your tricep should be burning a little bit. You should feel the muscles saying, okay, yep, I'm being worked. Alright, so let's go into the last set. We're getting through this pretty quick, guys. Four, three, two, one. All right, great. We are halfway done this work. Well, we're more than halfway done this workout. We got one exercise left, and that's body ups. Again, that's gonna work your triceps. I always say it's good to have some good looking triceps because they're the ones that stick out the most. Like, people look at your biceps, but when you're in a toned, when you want a toned up arm and you want shoulders, you really want to make sure those triceps are up to par with the biceps and the shoulder. So it's great to work all of it. Okay. So I'm just going to go into this. Make sure that you're using the palm of your hands so that they're not sliding too much. I am doing this on a yoga mat, which is why my hands probably slide a lot. But I really prefer doing it on a yoga mat than anything else. Okay? So let's get right into it. You could do alternating, or you can do it at the same time. All right, that's 8. I did those pretty quick. Those really hurt. So I think the next time I'll show the alternating, just in case. You can't do both arms pushing yourself, your whole body weight up. So, now step one, if you need a water break, take a water break. Make sure you're breathing and make sure you hold your core in. Alright, so this time I'm going to show the alternating. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Okay? So that's the alternating body ups. They're just as hard. But if you can't, seriously cannot push yourself up with both arms, which I couldn't do at first either. I'm still probably not doing them the best way right now. Then do the alternating. Probably gonna do the alternating again because I like that a little bit better right now. So, let's do our third set. Drink water, hold your core in, breathe. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so you can also do that up on your feet. You don't have to do it up on your knees. But if you're that good, go ahead. If you don't need your knees. So that's how I tone up my arms for the summer and get great looking arms for tank top season. I hope it helps. Like and share. Thanks for watching.